Does the Bible say anything about New Year resolutions? Probably not. But let's examine some things the Bible says that are related to New Year resolution.
New Year resolution simply means doing something differently in the new year.
As my sister earlier said, New Year resolution simply means doing things in a new way. Is there anything we didn't do right in the year 2020? Let's fix it now!
I would like to point out two verses that are related to New Year resolution in the Bible. The first one is Lamentations chapter 3 verse 40. Let us test and examine our ways and return to the Lord. And the second one is in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 17. Therefore, if any man is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. So let's begin the new things, glorious families. Happy New Year!
Good day, glorious parents and family. Happy New Year to you all! I'd like to share with you my New Year resolution. Please share yours with me also. As for me, no more grumbling when it's time for ministration. No more lying. No more being disobedient. I'll study my Bible 1 hour every day. So help me God. Thank you.
New Year resolution to talk on your phone and to go to sleep in the night, to wake up in the morning and to go to school. Eat some healthy food. I watch two Bible to toy the Bible.
Love yourself.
Happy New Year, glorious families and friends. Today I'm going to be sharing with you my New Year resolutions. Number 1, 1 hour reading of Bible daily. Number 2, no more lies. Number 3, no more being disobedient. Number 4, no more swearing. Number 5, help more people in my community. Number 6, help my mom more. Number 7, I will stop arguing with my siblings. If you don't mind, can you please share yours with us too? Thank you.
Good day, glorious families and friends. Happy New Year to you all. I'll count 1 to 3 when I'm angry to calm down. I will warn siblings first before I tell on them. The first thing I'm going to do for the new year is that I will read at least one chapter of the Bible, eat at least one chapter of the Bible every day. And I will spend 1 hour on Bible studies, either in the morning or at night.
Thank you.
Good day, Daddy Glorious, Mommy Glorious, Baby Glorious, all glorious families at home. So, my name is Oluwaseun. I am a parent, I'm a mother, and this message is not only just for mothers, it's for mothers, fathers, you know, children, most especially children, and everyone, all families, all glorious families in the world. So, we are just here to share our you know, our New Year resolution to everyone. We want to share with you all. So the kids have shared theirs, and I want to share mine as a mom, as a Christian, as a parent, you know, and as a guardian, because I'm just a guardian to the children of God, you know. So I have this New Year resolution with my between me and my kids. You know, there are things I do that I know I'm not perfect as a mom, which I want to make. I have made some promises with my children that I'm going to stop. So, and some of these things are. You know, treating ourselves with respect. That is number one. Treating ourselves with respect. You know, there's a way we can respect our children. I think I've not been doing that enough. So, I want to grow more on that. Mm-hmm. We can teach, we can treat them with respect in so many ways. Like in, you know, probably they are outside, want to talk to them, though I've not failed in that aspect. But when I say I want to start treating them with respect, sometimes among themselves, when they do something wrong, you know, they don't want me to kind of disrespect them among themselves, like you talking to one of them in the midst of the rest. Sometimes some of them feel bad about that. So, and sometimes I tend to yell. Maybe because of the way I was brought up. I'm not perfect, and I'm still not perfect. Though I'm trying to work on myself, but I'm this kind of, I easily yell sometimes. So I'm also trying to work on that. So like when I say I want to start treating them with respect, I mean I want to stop yelling at least. I want to, you know, I will keep working on myself. I'm not perfect, like I said. And everyone has a way you were brought up, you know. We are all brought up differently, Sha. So that is it. Then number two. Okay, I've already said that, which is my point. Number two, yeah, I want to stop yelling at them because I know that is not helping at all. It rather makes them, you know, generally yelling is not fine. But sometimes kids, they push us to yelling. They push parents to yelling. But still, I still want to still work on it. I've seen some mom who talk to children in a better way. So I'm trying to be like that, you know. So anyway, so that's the second one. Then the third one is that I want to show them more love, you see. I want to try and show more love to them. Because children, all parents, all mothers, let me be specific, we love our children. We tend to spend more time with them. So that, you know, that makes them to kind of want to prefer their fathers more than the mothers sometimes. Because of the rapport between them and the mother. Because there's always this quarrel, there's always this shouting. There's always this, corrections that come every now and then. And it kind of end up being like you're nagging, you know. It comes to them like your own is too much. So things like that, you know, the familiarity between mothers and the children makes the mother to be too on this side of, you know, emphasis and all. So it makes sometimes they kind of, you know, want to prefer fathers because the fathers are less of talking, the less of interaction because the fathers are not always around. So I just want to start, you know, showing more love. What I do most times as a mom, though, when I caution my children or when I yell sometimes because they force me to sometimes, when I do that, I try to come back later and fix it. What do I mean by fixing it? I talk to them. I call them sometimes even in the night. Maybe you just mistakenly come down to pee. I call you to myself. When I see your eyes are open and you're conscious of yourself, I call you to myself. We gotta talk. I remind you what you did and I remind you what I did, you know, like, as a parent, maybe I yell or I talk to you or I shouted or I scolded you. I have to tell you, this is what I did. This is what I'm trying to do for you to learn. I'm not trying to be mean. Just try and understand, you know. So I try to preach it. I don't stop at yelling it or, you know, sometimes beating it. But I tend to now preach it like, okay, this is this. I talk to them. Like a friend. I make them feel like a friend. This is the reason why I beat. Don't do this again so that we can be best of friends. And I think that is also working. So what I'm trying to say is that what I'm saying, I want to show more love. You know, that is what, when we talk about love between mother and child, that is part of it. So because you tend to be telling them this is bad, and they are seeing just that, it may not work. Or let me say it will work, but it won't be enough. So let's do more of love too, like showing them more love, explaining things to them. This is why I had to beat you, and this is why I had to. And I always remind them, there is a time I will not beat you again. So now that I have to beat, now that I have to scold you, now that I have to caution you, now that I have to talk to you, now that I have to yell at you, now that I have to correct you, allow me to keep doing this so that things can get better, so that we can be better family, so that you can be a better person in future. So that is that about showing more love, meaning explaining more to them, not just coding and talking, later come call them and refer to what they did that caused the yelling or caused. So to give them hugs always, you know, like hugging them and making them feel like, at least when you hug a child, there's this love they feel. When you hug them, you put their head on your chest. Oh my God. Even you, as a mom, let your husband or your mom, you know, for mothers that still have mom, I don't have. Unfortunately, I don't have. So, for mothers that have, still have mom, maybe you go to your mom and explain things to your mom. And your mom place your head on her chest just to cuddle you, you know. You will feel that love. You will feel that love. So, I want to, I do the hugging, but not all the time. Maybe once in a while. So, I want to do more of it so that they can feel that love. Because I want to really show them how much I care. Because they really need to know that you care. They really need to know that they're not going to know very well. They're not going to know everything right now until they grow a little more matured. Then they are going to refer to, oh, my mom. I thought my mom was mean. I thought my mom was wicked. I thought my mom was this, you know. They will understand life better and they will be able to give the praises that we mothers deserve. So then another thing I plan is to cuddle them each time they need it. Sometimes my second baby girl, she wanna just cuddle. And the way she wanna cuddle, it might be when I am under pressure or when I'm kind of, you know, maybe my mind is not just settled at that moment, I don't know. Or I'm not just in a happy mood and she wanna cuddle. So sometimes I just like, let me be, you know. I just wanna be. But when I see her reaction or how she feel like probably I don't love her, I will just have to hold that pain and cuddle. So, you know, all of these lapses is not because African moms are not good, but sometimes it all depends on your parents. If you didn't grow up that way, you know, you will have to work it out to be that kind of mom. Or let me say that kind of parent. So I'm trying to work it out. So another thing is to help them fulfill the good dreams that they have, you know. Whatever that can make them happy in life, I'm ready to support and make them, you know, achieve it. I know they have, you know, like kind of, they enjoy doing some stuff, which I sometimes deprive them of doing. I sometimes deprive them of doing them because of one thing leading to another. So now I have promised, okay, you're going to be having these things done, like games, like they love gaming, they love watching movies, you know. But when I ask them to do stuff, or probably they didn't do their schoolwork well, I deprive them of doing those. And that's the best way I could do it. So, but now I'm just going to make it a free, you know, like kind of a free choice. Make your choice. You finish your work quickly. You help me with some of the house chores which I've assigned to you. As long as those things are being put in better shape, then you have your 2 hours of gaming or 2 hours of movie. Or you can divide your 2 hours, 1 hour for gaming, 1 hour for movies. So now I make them have a choice. Not like before that I have to just deprive them completely. I give them a choice. So it is your choice. If you want to have the movie or you want to have the gaming, you just have to do the right thing. I also promise to, I usually help them with their schoolwork, but now I want to give more time to that. Because sometimes I realize that my son, my firstborn, he struggles with some things about his work. But because he feels he's a big boy and he can handle it, so he just keeps quiet, he will not bring it to me. Now I realize that there are some things he can't handle. So sometimes I just say, okay, anybody needs help. So, you know, all of them, they bring things for help. But for him, he want to just show that I'm a big boy, I can handle things. Their meal, get them ready for their school and be ready to help. Even for those who will not call me for help, I will just have to do a word round like the like the doctors do in the hospital. Anybody need help? Is there any area you're having issues? Can I come in? Can I say something? Can I do something? So I'm also trying to do that. Because even if there is nothing they need help with, at least that will make them, you know, that will give them kind of some more joy and confidence and make them know that I care. So another thing is, I also promise to take them out at least once in a week. I know some mothers do this, but I am kind of having some issues because of how my little ones behave when I go to public places. So I don't, sometimes I don't want to handle that. I don't want to start going after anyone. So I would rather keep them at home. Then because of this pandemic all around, I decided to, so they've been staying home. Apart from the fact that they, you know, I took them out on Christmas, 26th of Christmas, they didn't go out, you know, since the pandemic, since March, they've been home.
So now I've decided that, okay, because they are getting bored, really. They are really getting bored. So I've decided that, okay, I'll be taking you out once in a week at least. So another thing is, you're not taking them out to help them. It teaches them a lot. It exposes them, not wrongly. It exposes them to things they should know. It teaches them how to feel among in the midst of others, their peers, you know, how to comport themselves and to compose themselves, how to... It teaches them a lot. It makes it, they learn. Each time they see things, they learn too. So it adds to their life experiences. Then another thing is no more... Oh, let me not say... Okay, for Nigerian moms, maybe you will understand that. So the next point is teach us them. Okay, to teach them the word of God. Okay, so the word of God, when we talk about our morning devotion, it's more like I usually preach to them. We preach to ourselves. My children preach to me sometimes. You won't believe it. That is why I always encourage parents, mothers, because we are mostly with these children. You have to create a time for preaching. You are a minister, mothers. You are a minister. Preach the gospel. If you don't know how to preach to them, just use any of your church devotional booklet. You know, deal with the devotion every day, and from there, read the message to them. You will even, a lot of things you will say will be coming out from the message. Life issues and all. So you will read it to them, you will teach them, you preach to them. So your first church members are your children. So mothers, please write that down. Your first church members are your children, and probably your husband if he's available. So, no more. Okay, teach them the word of God. And another thing which we are still going to do, that is going to be a video on its own, is about reading the Bible for the whole of this year. We want to finish Bible for the whole of this year. It's a tax for every parent. We are still going to talk about that, not in this video. Thank you. I'm just giving you a tip. So another thing is, so that's one point I wanted to bring out. I want to help them finish the whole book of the Bible before the year runs out. And we're going to give testimony concerning that, because that's going to help me too. I've been promising that I was going to finish the whole book of the Bible, but unfortunately I couldn't. So this year, 2021, in Jesus' name, no matter what the devil tries, we will achieve it. No distraction, no laziness, no procrastination. Please give me one more point. No whatever. We must do everything we are supposed to do. So make them more delicious meals. So I'm going to be making them more delicious meals. So one more thing is that we are planning a video soon. It might come out this week. This video is going to be about the jar of gratitude. So I'm not going to tell you what that means. So we will see you in our next two videos. So our next two videos is going to talk about the jar of gratitude. It's going to talk about another video is going to be on how we are going to manage to read the whole book of the Bible. I mean, even if adult does not want to do this, if a grown-up doesn't want to do this, mothers, daddies, you are giving excuses, please, I don't know how you're going to do that. Just ensure these children will do it with the Bible. We will talk more about that. That's the second video. So there's this another video that is coming. It is about rapture. That is third video. Fourth video is coming. It's going to be about a trip to Disney World. You really need to see that video. You're going to really have fun. So there's another video coming up. That is also going to be a video about snow. So we have about five videos to throw at you, and they are coming so soon. Love you all. God bless you. Shalom.
Fuck, 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 fuck.